Hello, everyone. I thank you all for taking the time to join us this session today. My name is Adarsha Kutru, and I'm a database specialist SA. So let's get started with Amazon RDS blue-green deployments. Previously, if you wanted to make updates to your Amazon Aurora and Amazon RDS databases, you could use one of the two methods. You could do what we call an in-place database update, where you simply overwrite your older database with a new version. The problem with making updates this way is that in-place updates can lead to long, unpredictable downtime and can risk the safety of your production workloads. As a result, you must decide between prioritizing the availability of your database and staying current with the most recent database versions, which usually include important security patches and new capabilities that improve your performance. The other way you may update your database is by using Amazon RDS database cloning and read replicas to create a self-managed staging environment that stays up to date with your production environment. So in this method, you must create and manage your staging environment and perform the safety checks before manually promoting your staging environment to be the new production system. So this method of making database updates is costly to build and manage, and also requires considerable orchestration of resources and careful planning. While safer than the first option, the in-place updates, this method is also not foolproof, and you are unable to control the actual downtime of your workload. To ensure that you no longer have to make a choice between the availability and security or performance of your database, we created Amazon RDS blue-green deployments. So Amazon RDS blue-green deployments is a fully managed feature for Aurora with MySQL compatibility, RDS for MySQL, and RDS for MariaDB that makes the database updates safer, simpler, and faster. With blue-green deployments, updates to production databases are as fast as a minute with zero data loss compared to hours when using in-place updates that we talked in the previous slide. Blue-green deployments allow you to safely test the database changes in a staging or a green environment without impacting your current production or blue environment. Blue-green deployments use switchover guardrails that help you to ensure that database promotions happen safely. So by using a few clicks in Amazon RDS console, you can now create a production-ready green environment. Once your green environment is ready for promotion, you can initiate your switchover with one additional click. So in addition to major and minor version upgrades, you can make variety of common database updates such as schema changes, engine parameter changes, instance scaling, and maintenance updates using blue-green deployment. So how does blue-green deployments work? In Amazon RDS console, by using a few clicks, RDS will automatically create a green environment that mirrors your blue environment, including any in-region read replicas. This environment will keep your green primary database up to date with your blue primary using logical bin log replication. Once the green environment is provisioned and available, you can begin to make and test changes. You can also add or remove replicas in your blue and green environments. However, as a best practice, we recommend that you make minimal to no changes to your blue environment configuration so that the switchover is straightforward. So once you confirm that you are ready to promote these changes to production, you can initiate the switchover. We also have blue-green deployment switchover guardrails, which we'll discuss more in the upcoming slides. We'll also see switchover in action as part of the demo today. Since any writes happening to your blue environment are being replicated to the green environment, instead of taking hours depending on your workload, you can actually complete your switchover in under a minute. You can do all this without any application changes. That means Amazon RDS handles the endpoint changes for you. So this is beneficial if you have multiple applications connecting to the RDS endpoint. So after the promotion has been completed, RDS will not delete your old blue environment. So it is important, if you no longer need your older blue environment, please delete it to lower your costs. So blue-green deployments is available in all AWS regions. It is available for Amazon Aurora MySQL compatible edition versions 5.7 and higher, RDS for MySQL versions 5.7 and higher, and also for RDS MariaDB 10.2 and higher. So let's see how actually the switchover works in blue-green deployments. So you can go to the console and call for a switchover once your blue-green deployments are active. So you can specify a switchover timeout period between 30 seconds to 3,600 seconds based on your application's recovery time objective, which is also known as RTO. If the switchover takes longer than the specified duration, then any changes are reverted back. So once you actually enable or switch on that button switchover on the RDS console, Amazon RDS will run the guardrails check to verify if the blue-green environments are ready for switchover. So we'll do an instance health check, replication health check, replication errors check, also long-running transaction check. And if all the conditions are met and they look good, we go ahead and stop the write operations on the primary DB instances in both the environments, which is essentially by setting the DB parameter read-only to one. So after that, we drop the connections to the DB instances in the both the environments, and we obviously don't allow any new connections at this point. Then we wait for all the writes on the blue to be drained and all the replication on the green is caught up. So once that has been completed, the next step is to rename the DB instances. So the way renaming works is that the green instances get the name of the current production, which is your blue instance name, and blue gets renamed to hyphen or dash old. As a result, customers don't have to make any kind of changes on the application side. All the new connections are directed to green environment after switchover automatically. So once the renaming has been done, we allow the connections to both the environments. We enable writes on the primary instances for the new green environment. The blue instances with the blue dash old endpoint after switching over, we don't allow the writes automatically until it's rebooted. So that is to make sure that no stale writes are going there, and we kind of help sort out any caching issue. So this is basically how switchover works in a nutshell. So let's briefly look at pricing for Amazon RDS blue-green deployments. So we charge customers today for resources provisioned. So whether it's blue or green, the cost is no different. As the green is mirrored from blue, we essentially pay the same cost as blue environment for green environment as well. So if you have features enabled like backups, performance insights in the blue environment, they'll also be enabled on green by default and incur charges. And also, if you're using reserved instances for a specific instance class in the blue environment, we do take that into consideration for green environment as well. So essentially, you are paying 2x cost for running your workloads once the blue-green deployments has been enabled. Now let's look at RDS blue-green deployments in action. So here I am on my RDS console screen. So this is my demo instance, which is of 5.7 MySQL Aurora 2.10.2 version. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a blue-green deployment for this particular instance. My major intention here is to apply the blue-green deployment to perform a major version upgrade for this instance. So one of the key aspects before you go ahead and create is that you need to make sure that you have the bin log enabled for this cluster. Otherwise, the blue-green deployment will be failed to create. So you'll get a notification saying the bin log is not enabled. So to create a blue-green deployment, go to the Actions menu and choose Create Blue-Green Deployments. So give a blue-green deployment name. And then here, this is an important setting. So here we choose whether we want to go with the current version or we want to go with the target major version, right? So I'm going to choose the recommended version, the 8.0 MySQL Aurora 3.02.2, which is the latest version. And then if you're using DB cluster parameter group, a custom one for your 5.7 instance, then you will have to create a custom one for your Aurora 8 cluster as well. So I'm going to choose a custom parameter group here. And then that's all the settings for creating a blue-green, because it's literally mirroring your blue environment to green. So now we are going to go ahead and create the staging environment. Before I hit the button, I just wanted to show that you can see your estimated monthly costs, how much you are going to pay for the green database if you're running for a month. So that gives you an idea on how the cost, what kind of cost is going to add up. So let me go ahead and create staging environment here. So this may take some time because it has to provision the instances and also perform the major version upgrade. So I have already created a blue-green deployment here with similar configuration, where I have MySQL 5.7 as the blue environment here and MySQL 8.0 as the green environment here. So what I'm going to show you here is the naming convention, right? So if you see the naming convention, the green environment is created with almost the same name, except you have this hyphen green followed by a code here. So when you're actually renaming, what happens is we remove this particular appendix here, and then we just append hyphen old to this particular cluster. So without further ado, let's actually look at a couple of settings here on the blue-green deployment. So here you can see the comparison between the blue and the green, all the network settings, and also the VPC settings. So this gives you an idea if you have to make any changes to the network settings. And once you have confirmed, and then in the monitoring section, I would definitely recommend you to take a look at the replication lag, which is this metric, Aurora binlog replication lag metric, and make sure this is showing up as zero. So this means that there is no replication lag between the blue and the green environments. So once you have verified that, you can choose this blue-green deployment option here, and then go to actions and then click switch over. So in the switchover, you have a switchover summary, like what are the differences. As you can see, the cluster parameter group and the engine versions are a couple of main differences here. So once after you verify this information, if you want to reduce the timeout setting or increase the timeout setting based on your application RTO, change that duration. So I'm going to keep it as default, which is the 5 minutes. And then I'm going to click switchover. So what happens now is that we are going to make this as our primary production instance. And then as part of the switchover, we are going to remove this hyphen green appendix. And then we are going to make this as the primary. And then this blue instance will have an -old tag to it. So one thing to note here is that once after your blue environment is tagged with hyphen old, it is not allowing writes anymore. So it is only allowing reads. If you want to allow writes, you will have to reboot the instance. So if we see the database Aurora blue-green deployment, you can see the switchover is now complete. So as I had told earlier on, the green environment has now become a standalone production cluster here. And then the blue environment has been tagged with hyphen old. Now there is no longer any replication between both the instances. So thank you. That concludes the demo. Thank you. That brings us to the end of the session. Thank you all for joining the session today. Have a great one.